Hello, and welcome to our very first episode of the MystiCast. I'm your host, Kevin Gutman. During each episode of the MystiCast, we hope to bring you the sights and sounds from around BSC in the Bismarck Mandan community. Every video you see was shot, edited, and produced by the students in the video production class here at BSC. The first clip we're going to show you may come as a surprise, but we thought it deserved to be at the top of our show.
Mine? Well, mine's about this big.
Mine is this big.
Mine is this big.
Dude, mine is this big.
It's true. I seen it.
Yeah. Guess what? I have one too, and it's this big.
What are these people talking about? Not their anatomy, but their credit score. Which isn't just the subject of fun commercials with catchy jingles, but a number. A number that can affect your ability to get a loan, a car, or even a job. So in the case of credit scores, remember, size does matter. So tell me, how big is yours? If you don't know it, find out. You owe it to yourself to start your adult life with a great credit score.
Oh yeah, ladies, you love it. Well, the weather outside right now is not exactly ideal for riding motorcycles. But several weeks ago, BSC student Cody Martin found himself enjoying the last bit of nice weather. Stick around, there's more MystiCast to come.
tons of batteries are thrown away every year, causing toxic metals like mercury, lead, cadmium, and nickel to absorb into our environment. When destroyed, those toxins can cause cancer. So please, recycle your batteries.
BSC's newspaper, The Mystician, has been run by the students for 72 years and is currently advised by Karen Bauer. BSC's culture, news, and events are included in every paper. Pick up yours today at pickup points all around campus.
Come down to the BSC Aquatic Center. You might meet someone new.
Welcome back. I recently visited with students who learned about the distillation simulators used in the energy field. Here's what they had to say.
I asked Lucas Galstead what the students were doing for the day.
And what they're doing is they're actually separating water from methanol. And then what we have over off to the other side here is this is just a much larger version of the distillation. This is mainly what you'd see in an actual refinery.
The students legitimately enjoyed class. I asked Ryan Kai if he had anything to do with
it. I don't know if I cultivate it, but it's okay to see that they are enjoying it. So, I mean, I don't want to necessarily limit it.
Lucas Galstead wasn't aware of all the programs offered at BSC.
I absolutely love it. I didn't really expect it to be this in depth. And to hear about how much money they make and how immersive the job is really kind of opened up to my eyes at how big and wonderful this career can be.
Ryan Kaya said that it's important for students to have a wide variety of skills and a good portfolio in order to get employment after BSC.
If they just stayed on oil refining, they may be limited. They'd have to look at across the whole country. If they decide to do oil refining, biodiesel, and ethanol, they can actually probably be more regional.
Ryan Kai would like the students to spend more time doing labs and experiments so they could do it by memory.
That's just it. There's just enough time. Like, really, I wish they could do this 10 or 20 times. I mean, they should be able to start this from their memory and know how to do it.
Right now, the BSC Energy Department offers a variety of programs. For more information, please check out the website on your screen. According to a recent report by Morgan Stanley, the iPad is on track to become the world's most popular mobile device. Bismarck State College recently purchased 30 of them. Here is Skylar Snyder to tell us more.
Janelle Masters explored the idea to use technology to replace pen and paper for faculty evaluations.
In the past million years of BSC's existence, we've always done faculty evaluations by hand. Right? Students would fill out, you know, the whole thing, write it out. Then all these thousands of pieces of paper would go to a secretary who then would type it up and compute it. It was a lot of man hours, a lot of paper.
First, students used computers to evaluate teachers on SurveyMonkey.com using computer labs.
How about those students that just can't get to a computer lab, or it's just too much trouble, it's too far away? And so that's the genesis of the mobile iPad. So we'll just take in the 30 iPads into a class, distribute them, and they can go to the URL and fill out the evaluation.
Scott Helfrey introduced the idea to use the iPad for faculty evaluations.
You can have, say, maybe a technical course where you may have, in an online class, you might have animations, say, of a piece of machinery, but you miss out on that with a regular paper textbook. Well, you can combine those and bring that into the textbook and maybe see a cross-section of some type of equipment or something to that effect.
Currently, BSC is exploring other ways to integrate the iPad into the classroom.
Additionally, things like biology and whatnot, they're starting to be able to roll over to include more than video, to where you might have a three-dimensional image of a heart or an internal organ that you can actually take your finger and you can actually tumble that organ and get a 3D view right in your textbook.
Stay tuned to the MystiCast. You do not want to miss these student-produced commercials.
Ready for BSC basketball?
You ready?
Got 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason to remember the name.
Oh. Cattle producers across the state are moving their herds home. It is important that you pay attention to cattle crossing signs and allow cattle producers the time and road they need. Remember, the fastest way to move a herd of cattle is slowly.
In November, area high school students joined the BSC Choir for Choir Fest. It was capped off by a performance at the Belle Mayhew's Auditorium in downtown Bismarck. Here's Eric Manzalowski with the story.
An immense concert just took place. Bismarck State College held its 16th annual Choir Fest concert with guest conductor Bruce Chamberlain recently. First-year choral director Andrew Miller told us what he hoped BSC and high school students took from this experience.
I know they're going to be intense. I know they're going to be enlightening. They're going to be very educational and very inspiring. I think the students will come out of the clinic work with Dr. Chamberlain feeling like they've added some vital new elements to their singing and to their musicianship.
Students at BSC hope that high school students had received a positive outlook at BSC.
Basically, a really good opportunity for high schools around the area, especially kind of nearby in some of the smaller towns and everything, and surrounding high schools to get an opportunity to sing with BSC and kind of see what it's all about and the opportunities it has to offer.
The Choir Fest concert had performances from BSC's wind ensemble, men's choir, women's choir, chamber choir, and concert choir, with the jubilant of Central Dakota Children's Choir and the Choir Fest Festival Chorus.
Two BSC students from the theater program were nominated for the highly acclaimed Irene Ryan Scholarship. Alex Johnson tells us more about the students and their future journey.
Recently, Bismarck State College had its fall play Comic Potential, which was a huge success. But the best news involved two of the main actors and came just after the show was over. A judge from Northern University watched the production and chose one boy and one girl to represent BSC at the American College Theater Festival and compete against others in hopes of the highly acclaimed Irene Ryan Scholarship. These two people are Ashley Clouton, who played the main character JC, and Derek Harper, who played the doctor and father. Each were asked about their achievement.
It's a huge, huge honor to be chosen.
It's an amazing, amazing, amazing compliment. It's amazing to be chosen out of such amazing, talented people.
Out of the 12 people in the show, these two were very lucky to be nominated. But did either of them expect to receive the award?
Nope. Sure didn't. Nope.
They were asked what it means then, as an actor, to go to ACTF, with the same response.
It means that I get to be nervous a lot.
Kind of a work on the nerves. You know, some of these are huge universities that we're going against.
And they have plenty to be nervous about. The work is just beginning for these two talented people.
You have to prepare three pieces, two partner scenes that are contrasting, so one serious and one that's a comedy, and then a monologue as well.
You get a lot of great experience from going.
Ashley and Derek, along with the other theater members, leave for Iowa at the beginning of January for the American College Theater Festival. Break a leg, you two.
Everyone here at the MystiCast staff would like to wish them good luck with their upcoming competition. Well, that's it for the very first episode of the MystiCast. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. See you next semester.